Hey everyone, what's up? So I haven't put up any origami tutorials for about 3 weeks. I was off in Italy, attending the origami convention there, and then I came back and I had quite a few gigs, and then I had a cold, and well, anyway, enough excuses. I am going to make an origami tutorial, and I have had a lot of requests to make the Labyrinth Walker. This is a model I designed. Well, I didn't actually design it. This was a pattern that was designed in ancient civilizations all over the world. They just came upon this singular pattern, and it goes all the way around, all the way to the center. And this is from a sheet of whinstone, about 28 inch, and on the back of it, it's laminated with a sheet of Tyvek, and it's painted with acrylic paint and a permanent marker pen for the lines. So I'm going to show you how to fold it, but I'm not going to do so much coloring. We'll just do little permanent marker pen. All right, ready, set, here it goes. This is a model that I designed and published in my book, Origami to Astonish and Amuse. So, page 117, and I'm gonna use a sheet of whinstone. This is 20 by 14, some piece of paper that I got in Italy. Light green whinstone marble, wow. I've never seen this color of whinstone, so I was really excited to find some. All right. So, just gonna make it square, 14 by 14. Okay. So we're gonna start out by making a water bomb base. So, fold it in half, and fold the right corner up to the top. And then turn over, and fold the right corner up to the top. Okay, now open and put your hand in the large pocket and open it up so much that we flatten it down. Like this. And it is a water bomb base. So, we're going to divide this height into 16. So let's first fold up the middle, make sure that you have a very good middle crease there. Okay, and fold right to that same crease. And rotate, and let's fold this edge up to the same crease. So here we have fourths. One, two, three, four. So let's do eighths now, so let's rotate. Fold this corner up to the last crease. And fold the corner to the first crease. Alright, let's fold this edge to the first crease. And let's fold right up to the second crease right here. So we're folding the raw edge up the second crease, and that'll complete the eighths. Okay, so we have eighths. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Now we need sixteenths. So, turn over, and what we're going to do is, let's make the second crease. There's one, two, like the second crease right here. And just lift it up like this, and we're going to flatten it onto the first crease. So we push it down, and notice that right in between, that makes a new crease, a new valley fold. Okay, now let's The next one, lift this crease up and fold it right on the edge. And just continue in the same way, go all the way down. So lift it up and fold down. Lift up and flatten. Again. And again. And lastly, just fold the corner up. And we have to do it right over here, so let's turn over. Fold it down. And fold the edge up. Okay, so we have divided the height of the water bomb into 16. And now we're going to completely unfold. So gotta zoom out again. All right, so the only folds that really need to be changed are going to be within the 16 by 16 units square right here. So we need to make a grid on that square. So let's count 8 over, let's start right here. You see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And this is the 8th. Just extend that one up, and let's do the same thing on this side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Extend this up. If you want, you can fold the edge right to the middle crease. That's another way to find that 8. So here we have our square, and let's make all of these creases that go in this direction. So you can lift this up and fold it right to the side, right to the crease. And you only need to go right down to here, but anyway. Okay, same thing on this side. So lift up the crease and fold it to the middle. Alright, we have 4s, 1, 2, 3, 4, let's do 8, there, and same thing on this side, okay, and let's turn over, and there's our square. Let's do the final eighths right here. So we take, here's our center crease, and we just go right to the very next crease down, lift it up, and fold it onto the center. And same thing on this one, lift it up, and fold it right on to the center. So turn it over again. So here is our square, and we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Shall we do 16ths? Okay, so 16ths, you just have to put a crease in between each one of these creases. So that. That. Same thing over here. One. Two. Now what we're gonna do is, let's make the sunken water bomb. So we start out, we're gonna go around the edge like this. And when you get to the corner, you just let the corner stick up. Take this edge and we fold it up, and the same thing on the neighboring edge, and with the corner you just pinch it and let it stick up. This is like the two interlocking rings, which is quite a bit simpler since it's only dividing into fourths instead of sixteenths. For the interlocking rings, click here. Sticking up, let's turn over and do the same thing. Now make sure that you notice where the grid folds are. Just always keep track that this is where we made all of these vertical creases. Because when we unfold it, you're going to want to remember that. Because that's where we have to make all of the new folds. More here. And the last one will look like that. And now just squeeze so we have the sunken water bomb base. Alright, and I can see when I open it, you have to open it, the place where I have the grid of creases is right here. So put that part closest to you. Carefully open up, try not to tear the paper. That would be bad. Okay, now you don't have to do this, but I like to draw the lines on it because I think when showing an audience, it's just they can see it a lot better if there's actual lines that are drawn on. So here's your grid. We're just going to start out by drawing on the lines that go into these three sections right here. 1, 2, 3. So we're not gonna do any drawing in this triangle and this triangle right here. It's just in this triangle, and this triangle. Okay, so here we go. Start out, we're going to count 1, 2, and we're gonna go from this diagonal line to this diagonal line. So we start right here. Okay, like that, and we're gonna do the same thing on the three remaining triangles that are not on the graph. Okay. Okay, now we need to make the middle crease that goes 4 units. So the middle crease. So it's actually 8 little units. So we're gonna start right at the middle. Right there, and I'm gonna go down 1, 2, 3, 4 units. Okay, let's make that a little darker. Alright, and now I'm going to attach these two. Okay. Now we're going to make a little square right here. This is the heart of a labyrinth. And it actually turns out that it's like a flasher. So we're going to make another line that goes from the top of the square to this line right here. Okay, and we're going to make a line that goes from the remaining corner of the square down to here. You see how that is like the center of a flasher? Okay, and now let's make this come up like this and to here. So it goes up here, and then right over to here, like that. This is the center of the labyrinth. And now this right here comes up to here and over and connects with this line, like that. Okay, and now let's make this, which comes up to right. Here it stops, and it's like that, stops right there, and stops right here, and we connect these two. And here, like that. And we're gonna do the same sort of thing right here. So we go take this line and extend it right here. So that's 2 units there. And now we're going to take this line, which is right here and goes right like this, and then connect up like that. And now let's just make the outer line. So make sure that you don't make it right along here. Let's just put it right along the edge. And I have this scrap paper, well, the package of paper here, down on the other side so that I don't mark the table. Make sure that you stop before the end so that we leave this thing open. Okay, so here we have the pattern, and now we're just going to remake the water bomb. So that means these three quadrants right along the existing creases. So when I was designing this, I just started with the original Cretan labyrinth, and I was like wondering if it could possibly be done out of origami. And since the original one is round, I knew that round folds don't flatten, so I made it square. And this is pretty much the original pattern that I put down, and I just, you know, tried to see if it would fold up. Not only did it fold up, but it actually became a person. That was a big surprise. Cool. Okay, so now we're going like this. And just pinch out and fold like that. And obviously the valley folds are between the lines. Okay, now the inner part here, we're going to make a valley fold that comes right to here. So in other words, we put these two lines, bring them together, and a valley fold that goes right in that little square. Now let's push it together. It'll almost happen automatically. Push it together with all of the folds in place. Okay. That's what it should look like. The line comes there, boom, and back up. is the head right here. And now I just squeeze the square together. This is like this, the corners squeezed. Head. And now you just want to make the arms, so the joints of the arms. So there's an elbow, and there's a hand. And you can really do it in any way you want. Guideline, just a taste. And there it is. And there's the man. It opens up. And there's the labyrinth walker. It goes round, round, round. Looks like we're going to the outside again, but no, we're going inside. And there it is. All right, well, I hope you had some luck folding that, and bye-bye.